Back, I'm about down where I need to be. Thought I'd stop by my buddies and rouse him up. He ain't home, and get a picture of the Massey to decide he's 4630. So, yeah, he's got a really nice 4630. This is the Legends 4630, actually, sees it is. So, yeah, there we go. Did you see this Legend? He's even got the grandpa steps. Because he's old. So, yeah. We'll side by side. 46 and 11:30. Alrighty. There's something, it's probably in every area. I know it's in my area. That's, local grocery store, so I believe. Got a beer bottle. Heck, the old Massey don't look too bad sitting here in front of the old IGA in Clay City, Indiana. Go ahead and got me a sandwich, some chips, because I'm a farmer. So, yeah. Got meat belly. Yeah, alrighty. I'm going to eat here. Open up. Alright, we're back here in a few minutes or something else we had to do. Back and excuse me, then made a couple rounds. The old Massey plowing. This ground's really sandy, it's turning over really nice and easy. So, thought I'd do a quick walk around. First, I've had the Massey out basically, other than a little bush hogging. Make sure I ain't got any major leaks or something weird. And Firestones are, whew, they're hooking up, man. So, they're starting to shine. So, we'll, looks like I got a seal leaking on that cylinder right there. Make sure to back road it going home in case that
blows. Yeah. Not looking bad.
Well, Massey's got a little blow by. Due for an overhaul, but eventually. See how good I can do this. Need a tripod or something. It'd be nice, but I ain't got one. We've been running in third gear. Once I get going, I'll throw the multipower up, but third gear high on the multipower. So see what we got here. Teach you guys a little something here in a little bit. We're getting it rolling. Come on, Massey!
Thank you.
take a little break. Show you guys a little something. Set a plow up, you're gonna have a dead furrow. That's all right. This is called your dead furrow. Before you start plowing a field, you gotta decide where that's gonna be, because that's what it's gonna end up you'll have, and somewhat of that. You can take your front of your plow and you can kind of push it back in. But the guy already set this up before I got here. So he's gonna have a dead furrow over there. He didn't want it over on the end. That's usually how I do them at my place, but for each his own. But yeah, you gotta think about where you want your dead furrow at the end of the day when you get done. So depending on where this ends up at, I'll probably try, and you can lift your back, or dang it, not your back, your front. Front of your plow and kind of try and move it in. But anyways, another thing, which I don't have this one quite right, I just didn't have time to mess with it. That's your plow point. This is a 1450. This is what I was told. I'm sure there's plowing experts. You want from the inside of your tire right here to this point, you want a 14 inch difference. That's what I've been told. This isn't, I measured it before, that's lacking about 3. Well, I can adjust it right here and move this part of the plow hitch over. Probably this hole here would probably get it. And no, I'm sorry. I want to move it away. So I want to would move this over that way. And is the way you would do that. Move it away from the tire. That's what I've been told. I'm no plow expert, but that's what a guy that's been doing it longer than me told me. So that's basically about it. It's a 5-bottom 1350-1450. And this John Deere hitch is made pretty cool. That kind of helps offset when you put it in there too. Hydraulic lines are needing replaced, but see, this ground is really sandy, so. But we'll get back on the tractor and do a little more plowing here. What do you think? Alright, we'll start plowing again. Trying to stay out of there. It's already got planted, so. Doing our best here on this field, I believe. Yeah. Yeah, we're getting here to the end when we got the two dead furrows to meet. I'll show you what y'all do with that. At least what I do. Yeah. Do a little more straight pipe action, make another round, then we'll go from there. A view from in the ground what it looks like. So there you go. Yeah, it's like the front, so running this deep, I have to keep watching lower the 3-point. It's good, 4 rack of weights, oh yeah. Alright, just gonna show you right there, we got dead furrow right here in the middle. Kind of where I was talking, taking care of that, go back in a little bit. Put the tractor tire in it. Don't race the back of the plow, or just use the damn plow. See how you kind of. Hard to film this. Do it. Kinda, you can see what I'm doing. You're moving the each of your first two plow shears or whatever. You can fill it back in best you can. That way you don't have a super trench. But yeah, it's kind of how I do it. Anyways, I'm about out of battery. This little field's about done, so I'm gonna wrap it up for today with the old Massey, the old John Deere plow. So.